chapters for monuments, contribution to sustainable management and future heritage preservation. The environment, natural or artificial, that surrounds a monument can strengthen or reduce the heat and humidity flows inside the construction materials and influence the degradation processes. Degradation is related directly to the heat and humidity flows through the mass of the structural elements, which are caused by the potential difference determined by the boundary conditions inside and outside of the walls. The hydrothermal evolution within is related to daily and seasonal cycles, such as the thermal energy transported through the soil and to the building elements, floor, walls, and roof, and water exchanges between soil and indoor air at all stages of concentration, which are in close relation to the heat exchange. Therefore, there is a need to intervene in this environment in order to control, as far as possible, the microclimate. Proper protection of heritage structures could be achieved by adjusting the microclimatic conditions. The main objective is to stop any potential damage induced process and to take precautionary measures for sustainable management and the future preservation of cultural heritage, which is a topic of the UNESCO Sustainable Development Goals, the SDG 11, make cities and human settlements inclusive, safe, resilient, and sustainable. The target 11.4, strengthen efforts to protect and safeguard the world's cultural and natural heritage. In the category of artificially created environment are included the built shelters that aim to protect the monuments from the influence of the weather conditions. As the very nature of these constructions contributes to the formation of the microclimatic conditions both inside the monument and around it using mechanical systems. Thus, in order to evaluate the shelter's contribution to the creation of the a stable microclimatic environment and minimization of heat and moisture exchanges, we need to define sustainable criteria and specifications for their construction, including the use of renewable energy systems to reduce energy consumption. As tourist activities are concerned, heritage sites should not be isolated from the visitors, but the visiting procedure should be controlled by management policies based on the principles of sustainability. Additionally, new demands for comfort and environment protection often require the upgrading of energy efficiency in historic buildings. There is still much discussion on which are the appropriate policies and management techniques to minimize the impact of tourists on monuments without them being isolated. In the photos you can see tombs in the area of Pella, Macedonian tombs, which were excavated and protected with shelters. Increasingly, it is being recognized that smart buildings and integrated systems are central to successfully addressing challenges posed by climate change. Natural disasters, accidents, disease, and terrorism. The ASHRAE Strategic Plan 2019-2024 includes the improvement of energy efficiency that is becoming increasingly important for the monument preservation. The climatic change endangers heritage buildings all over the world. Additionally, modern living standards may cause climatically problems for buildings. Only the ability to economical use ensures the heritage continued existence. Measures improving energy efficiency are only acceptable for heritage preservation if they are not directly destroy the historic value or disturb the lasting of the monuments. We're going to see the case of Macedonian domes shelters. Macedonian domes are subterranean monuments dated in the 2nd and 3rd century before Christ, excavated in the area of Macedonia and North Greece. They have been built by a large block of stones with a vaulted roof, having depicted walls of great archaeological importance. Their special characteristic is the artificial covering of earth named tumulus. Most of them have been preserved during the centuries in excellent condition, being in a stable microclimate, which is disturbed after the excavation works. About 100 Macedonian domes have been excavated in the whole region of Macedonia, and only a few of them have been protected with permanent shelters that include mechanical systems to control the interior microclimate. Best case studies until now are the royal tombs at Virginia, the tomb of Agios Athanasios, Thessaloniki, the Macedonian tomb at Derveni, Langadas, the shelters for Macedonian tombs at Athens and Myza in Athia, and the temporary shelters for Macedonian tombs at Pella. The royal tombs at Virginia, maybe you know and have visited the new museum that had been constructed over the tombs. It is very interesting that a tumulus-shaped shelter with a soil embankment was constructed to regulate the conditions of temperature and relative humidity in the interior and create a museum in situ. You can see the drawings of the study for the shelter that have covered about 5 and 6 tombs. The entrance of the tumulus is in the photo, and the whole shelter, you can see that it seems like a mound. In the tomb of Agios Athanasios, the facade is decorated with excellent paintings representing an ancient symposium. The housing shelter have been constructed to regulate the conditions of the interior. You can see the drawings of the shelter and the road that goes to see the facade of the tomb. And the drawing is the tomb as it was found. In the Veni, in Langada, it was found another tomb that is very important. And a housing shelter was constructed to regulate the conditions of the interior. On the right is the condition that the tomb was found many years ago, and the left and the left is the tomb as it is now. The Macedonian tombs in Athens, Myza, in Imathia were also protected by shelters, different kind of shelters and architectural design, but no mechanical systems are added to preserve the stable conditions. They were just protected by the exterior climate, rain and sunlight. The tombs at Pella, two tombs, very important and in very good condition, were excavated in the area of Pella. In this case, Only temporary shelters were constructed, and they did not include mechanical systems, and also they were open to the exterior air and the climate. So they didn't even protect from the air exchanges between the exterior and the interior area. So, the shelter as a microclimate regulator, there is much discussion about what a shelter for monuments should be like. Some of them, as we have seen, are permanent shelters. Some of them have mechanical systems used to regulate the conditions. Some of them are open to the air, to the exterior climate. So, in the following pictures, we will show different points of view of the issue. Even some of them are idealistic or imaginary. Some are temporary constructions, some are permanent to house and protect the heritage findings. We can see an ideal point of view about how a shelter would be to protect the Acropolis or an ancient monument in Mexico. They were not constructed, okay, of course. But it is an imaginary way to show that we need protection for monuments, and we need to protect them from the exterior climate. So, generally, there are two types of shelters. First, temporary protective covers, which provide protection against direct and visible threats, as rain, air, and light. And permanent buildings, or housing shelters, as we say, which ensure the control of in-climate conditions and possibly the correct setting to provide protection from indirect threats as humidity and temperature, that act as an unseen level, perceived only by its effects. Adverse effects of the housing shelters are externally, heating and expansion from solar radiation, rain moistening, drying and cooling from wind, dust and pollution from the traffic. Internal effects is air circulation, heating and cooling, saturation and diffusion of water vapor. What are the requirements for a shelter? The following questions should be answered. What do we want to protect the tombs from? Do they need protection from rain, sunlight and wind? Do they also need protection from the changes of microclimate conditions, the temperature and the related humidity? How should we achieve the control of the microclimate? What kind of shelters are we going to construct? And what will be the qualification and the properties of the materials to be used? The minimum requirements that the shelter must satisfy are a thermal insulation, protection from overheating in summer and the frost in winter, the temperature range to be reduced in the interior, with a phase delay due to the thermal capacity of the components, adequate heat capacity to prevent dew formation in winter nights, ability to receive and remove the moisture created indoors, resistant to water vapor diffusion, moisture storage and the moisture return, water vapor barrier. Double door entrances that protect from direct lighting and ventilation. Expansion properties control, thermal conductivity and water vapor permeability. Relationship between the volume and the outer surface of the shell. The smaller the outer surface compared to its volume, the smaller the heat loss. In trying to regulate the enclosure, we have specific data, conditions, and means of achieving the goal each time. The data include what do we want to house, the kind of findings, the material that are made from, for how long we want to protect them, whether or not human presence will be on site, what is the soil morphology of surrounding area, the climate of the place, what size of shelter is required, and what construction cost is required. Finally, the aesthetic parameter. The conditions or the requirements include acceptable limits for interclimate conditions, building opportunities, financial opportunities, and the means are appropriate architectural design and enclosure adjustment systems. Basically, the type of the housing shelter largely determines the interior climate and the cost of the support systems. The decision should be made after a survey of all the data needed. In order to evaluate the shelter's contribution to the creation of a stable microclimatic environment and the sustainable management of monuments, the present paper defines criteria and specifications regarding the construction of the housing shelter, the control of the indoor climate conditions, the properties of the construction materials, and the promotion of the monuments. The construction of the housing shelter should represent the least possible intervention, be constructed in a short time, do not burden the monument from human carelessness, machine vibration, etc. during the implementation and the construction, must be reversible and have a longer life, ensure conditions controlling maintenance, use HVAC and renewable energies, energy such as solar and geothermal, use of BMS automation systems, be functional, have static resistance, security, easy movement of visitors, and aesthetically harmonizing with the monument and the archaeological site, and finally emphasize the monument. The control of indoor climate conditions means minimize the exchanges between the inside and outside air, stabilize the temperature and relative humidity fluctuations, reduce the temperature difference between indoor and outdoor, reduce the number of the visitors and time spent inside, control the water and heat flows through the mass, and control flows between soil and building materials. We need a promotion also and the display of the monuments, because this is the way we construct a shelter to protect, but also to show and promote their value. So, we need to enhance the value of the heritage site, cultural and educational. Create a livable place for visitors and the surrounding residents. Aesthetic alignment and harmonization between new constructions, the monument and the surrounding area. Improve indoor comfort for the visitors. Best accessibility and transportation, and provide security and safe movement of the visitors. About the construction materials, we need them to have increased resistance to temperature changes, thermal insulation, heat capacity, and fire protection. They must not be easily affected by the humidity, not easily affected by air pollution, no chemical reaction with water or with the materials of the monument, compatible with the physical and chemical properties of the monument, no development of biological lesions, have specifications for a long service life, where traditional technologies require use of specifically produced materials that are not available on the market, and ensure the conditions, the continuous control and maintenance. Regarding the sustainable management and what that means for monuments, this is a very interesting issue. What sustainable management means for the preservation of the monuments. We need to safeguard them for the future generations, because this is the meaning of the sustainability. Preserve the key testimonial knowledge of the monument. Use of non-destructive methods and reversible constructions. Use of environmental-friendly methods to modify the surrounding microclimate. Reduce the energy consumption. Achieve efficiency and autonomy using renewable energy sources. Tailored retrofit strategies to be investigated and implemented. influence users' behavior and develop innovative solutions. Conclusions: artificially created environment for monuments includes built-in shelters that aim to protect them from the influence of the weather conditions. Proper protection of heritage structures could be achieved by adjusting the microclimatic conditions. The very nature of these constructions contributes to the formation of the microclimatic conditions both inside the monument and around it. The main objective is to stop any potential damage included process and to take precautionary measures for sustainable management. Smart buildings and integrated systems are central to successfully addressing challenges posed by climate change and natural disasters. The improvement of energy efficiency is becoming increasingly important for monuments preservation. Solutions more suitable for heritage buildings should be found in a wider range. Improving heat and light technology influence user behavior and involve urban possibilities. When it comes to develop innovative solutions that will not, in any case, harm the monuments. This is the goal, finally, not to harm the monuments but enhance their value. Thank you for your attention.